Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello student. Student, today we are going to learn our next lesson. Lesson number 26, a school teacher's thought. Okay. This is a monologue. The meaning of monologue is a long speech by one person. Okay, student. And student, remember, we already learned these types of one lesson we are having in this textbook. Remember it? Yes, correct. Before we already learned these types of lesson, which is lesson number 8, a honeybee speaks. Okay, this is also a monologue. Now see a student, what the teacher want to say to you, want to speak with you. Now see, first of all, I will read this lesson. You also read it after me. Okay, now see a student. Oh dear, a traffic jam. Will I reach late? Children will wonder why I have not turned up. I wish I could have started a little earlier today. But how? It's difficult with all the housework, cleaning, cooking, getting my children and their tiffins ready for school. But still, I see to it that I am never late to school. Okay. Now see a student, first of all, oh dear, a traffic jam. Will I reach late? The teacher asked her children, her student, that will I reach late today? Because you know, traffic is always jams. This is the reason behind it. Children will wonder why I have turned up. I wish I could have started a little earlier today. Okay. The teacher speak with the children that the reason behind it, the traffic jam, and I always try to come earlier to school, but I am having lots of work. For example, housework, cleaning, cooking, getting my children and their tiffins ready for the school. Student, you know, teacher is also playing the versatile roles. For example, she is a mother, she is a teacher, she is a wife, okay, and she is also caretaker to you and her family. So she explained you, I am also having lots of housework, cleaning my house, cooking, getting my children to ready to school, make tiffin for them, okay, and send them school. But still I see to it that I am never late to school. But see here, student, I follow my timetable. I am very punctual to follow the time. That's why I never late to school. I complete all this my housework. Then I reach to school to teach you your subject, your topics. Okay. Now see what is given in the next paragraph. I wonder if student know that teacher have homework too. Okay, so teacher is surprised here. Teacher, student, if I tell to you that I am also having homework, then you also surprised. Okay, but see, what is the homework teacher is having? Correcting their notebooks, text papers, planning how to make their lessons interesting and happy. Teacher is also having some homework. Okay, just like you. What is teacher's homework? Correcting your notebook when you write anything. At that time, teacher is there always to correct you. Okay. So, she correct your notebooks. She prepare your text paper. She planning for your each and every event. Planning for the exam schedule. Okay. Planning for the picnic, gathering. Okay. Everything. And how to make their lesson interesting and happy. Obviously, teacher is there always to help you, always make your lesson interesting, and she is always take care that you all are very happy when you learnt all this subject. It's not easy to keep so many children busy in their work. They seem to rest less. Yes. Okay, teacher is know that the child psychology, that's why teacher is not giving you the same work. She gives you the different activities, practicals, the different games. Okay, so that you feel fresh and energetic to learn the new topic or subject. Okay, now see in this next paragraph. In class, half my time is spent in solving their little problems, quarrels and complaints. They are endless. Okay, teacher is give you practical situation. She is facing this practical situation. What is this practical situation? See a student, all the student, they are not as a same, same nature student. Some they are very silent, some they are very goody, some they are very naughty, okay. So, they always disturb the class. They are always having the problems, say again and again, visit to teacher, tell teacher about the friends, complain teacher about their friends, about their classmates, okay. So, teacher is having little time to explain you, to solve you. She is always engaged to solving their problems, okay. So, and she know your complaints, your problems are endless. There is no end to your problem. If teacher is solving one problem, again the children having the another problem. Okay, that's why it calls endless problems. Now, next para. Now, don't think I am complaining. Not at all. I love all the children in my class. I think of them all the time. Okay, again teacher is explaining you, my dear children, I am not complaining about you, but I know I love my children and my class, but I only share with you my problems. I think of them all the time. I am always thinking about my children here also. And when I go to school, go to home, at that time also I think about my school and my children's, my student. How eager they are to show me what they do, how happy they look when I praise their work. Okay, now she knows, student, how you are very eager to show to your teacher each and everything. And I know, to student, you are also very eager to share your things, your problems, your family problems, your happiness, your sadness, share with your teacher, isn't it? And when the teacher give you the compliment about your work, it's very good, keep it up, at that time you are very happy, isn't it? They depend on me so much. That is why even when I am not well, I don't feel like missing school. So, student, see a student, the teacher is knowing you very well. Okay, so that she is explaining you that you all are very depending to your teacher. Okay, sometimes when the teacher is not present in the school, you ask about your teacher to the another teacher, why our teacher is not coming to school, you miss your teacher. Okay, so the teacher is also realize your feelings, and that's why when the teacher is not feeling at that time also, she never like to miss the school, because she always think about yourself. Okay, now see in next. I love being a school teacher. Where else could I be like a mom to so many loving kids for a few hours every day? See a student, at the end teacher is give you very good compliment that I love being a school teacher. I love my profession. I love my profession as a teacher. Okay, and where else could I be like a mom, where I am also playing two roles as a teacher and as a mom. Okay, so many loving kids for a few hours every day. To many loving kids, so she is very feeling very proud that she is having the lovely kids like you. Okay, student. Now see here, student, what happens sometimes if you are not feeling well at that time, your teacher is playing your mother role, isn't it? She call your parents, she take the care, lots of care to your care of you. Okay, and she is always there to give you the proper treatment whenever you are at the school. Okay, student. So it's a very nice lesson in which the teacher want to talk with you. She also express her thoughts with you. She also share all these thoughts, whatever comes in her mind. And at the end, she is telling you that she is very, she is very lucky that she is having this profession and she is always take care of everyone. Okay, student. Student, read this lesson aloud, okay, with proper tone, and also learn the new words coming to this lesson. Okay, thank you.